Welcome back. This is eNCA as we head up to 7:15 on this Valentine's Sunday. Good to have you with us. I'm Gareth Edwards. From a funeral to funeral-related fraud, the National Education, Health and Allied Workers Union, or Nehawu, wants the Eastern Cape Premier to fire Health MEC Sindiswa Gomba. Now, she's accused of involvement in a 10 million rand fraud, corruption and money laundering case. It's in connection with Nelson Mandela's funeral. Gomba and her co-accused are currently out on bail. On the Nehawu's Eastern Cape Secretary, Miki Jaceni, joining me to bring us their perspective into this particular story. Mr. Jaceni, always a pleasure speaking to you. So you want the Health MEC to be fired. The Eastern Cape Premier is saying he still has to make a decision. Where and why do you think this is taking so long?
Thank you for inviting us. We have been observing the developments in the Department of Health as the Nehawu leadership. And we have given the MEC plenty of time to correct some of the things that we have been raising with her office. But unfortunately, recently we have been calling for that office to meet with us and discuss key and pertinent things that are related to conditions of service and also the programs that are with the department, such as the rollout plan of the vaccine and many other things. But she has been refusing to meet with us. So the appearing in court was the last straw to us, because we can see that the MEC has got a divided attention. She cannot focus. So her political duties cannot be correctly administered. So we are saying to the Premier, she must withdraw the MEC from that department so that we can get somebody who can focus and give direction on the mandate that is given to that department.
There are going to be supporters, Mr. Jaceni, forgive me, there are going to be supporters of Ms. Gomba who are going to say, rather have her step aside while this investigation is ongoing and not remove her from the position. What's your stance on the stand-aside ruling in this case?
No, we've been consistent that that is a call of the Premier. Because to us, we have come to the conclusion that she cannot perform her duties diligently, and she has not been able to execute such duties efficiently and sufficiently. Because there are a lot of things that are not happening in the department. The variant that has caught us cannot be lowered, but we have got more than 11,000 people who have died in the province. So if the Premier so decides to put her in another deployment, that's his call. But what we are saying is that for the department to proceed unhindered, we need somebody who can focus on the money.
So you're calling for someone to step in and handle the role of the MEC while this is ongoing. Mr. Jaceni, speak to me about what your opinion is, your feeling is, after this court case. If the MEC is found to be not guilty, are you still going to be willing to work with her as Nehawu?
No. Well, I think we were embarrassed by the MEC appearing in court, because we know that even if she can continue to be in that department, she will not be able to deliver on the mandate. That's what we are saying. That is why we are saying we respect the rule of law, and also we know that Ms. Gomba is innocent until proven guilty by a competent court. So we cannot just interfere with what the Premier will do. But what we are saying for that department, with all the challenges that I've enumerated, we cannot be able to work with her going forward. Because really, the department is very much demanding. We have just had to call the office of the head of department to meet with us after she has refused to give us a hearing on many of the things for so many times that we have been in her office.
And when, as a final question to you, Mr. Jaceni, when are you expecting the Eastern Cape Premier, Oscar Moboyani, to make a decision? Are you pressuring him to make a decision? Have you got a timeline in mind?
Yes. We are just eager to know what decision is he going to make, because we have made this call for quite some time. So it would not be a difficult decision to make, because he knows himself as the premier what is the right thing to do. So we are saying he must immediately step in so that we can have somebody who will take that department forward.
I appreciate your time in speaking to us, Mr. Miki Jaceni, Nehawu, Eastern Cape, speaking to us here on ENCA.